Father, thank you that our many sins can be forgiven through our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for your promise to put our sin behind your back, to bury them in the depth of the sea, and to remove them from us as far as the east from the west. Let the blood of Jesus cleanse us from every sin. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Good morning. Happy New Day. Happy Monday, October 14, 2024. This is Love Word, taking you open heaven, a guide to close fellowship with God. In our custom, let's say, Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah is an heavenly language. Hallelujah song we never cease for our mouth in Jesus' name. Amen. The topic before this morning is cover not your sin. Cover not your sin. And let me first when we find the book of Proverbs 28, verse 13. I read, He that covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whoso covereth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. He that covereth his sin shall not prosper, but whoso covereth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. In my primary school days, our teacher told us the story of a man who offended his king. The king was very angry and called the man concerning the issue. The man immediately got on his knee and pleaded for mercy. He admitted his offense and said that he was very sorry. The king pardoned him because of a repentant heart. Our teachers told us that if you are wrong and may admit it, while asking for mercy, we will obtain mercy. However, if we try to cover our wrong, we will surely get punished. The lesson stuck with me, and so, when I do something wrong, I don't try to cover it. If I offend God, I turn to Him and say, Lord, I've offended you. Please have mercy on me. If you want to obtain mercy from God, you must not cover anything that you commit. The reason God always had mercy on David is that he never tried to cover his sin. Rather, he will confess them to God. In 1 Chronicles 21 verse 1 to 16, when God came to David that he had offended God, not only did David accept his wrong, he called the elders to fast and pray with him for forgiveness. Compare that to Saul in 1 Samuel 15 verse 20 to 21, after Samuel had come to tell him that he had not carried out God's instruction to the letter, he had made excuse instead of accepting his wrong. When Samuel refused to worship God with him, he did not plead with him to help appease God. Rather, he pulled Samuel's skirt just because he didn't want the elders to see Samuel walking away from him. He clearly wasn't making the sacrifice to ask for mercy. He was doing it to cover his sin and make everything look alright. 1 Samuel 3 verse 19 tells us that God honored Samuel and never allowed his word to fall the ground. But in 1 Samuel 16 verse 1, as much as Samuel pleaded for Saul, God said that he should not waste his time because he had rejected Saul and he has rejected him. Beloved, covering your sin will land you in destruction. When you do something wrong, don't try to keep up appearance. Your Christian life is not about publicity. It's more of your personal relationship with the King of Kings. Confess your sin and plead with God for mercy. When you do that, He will have mercy on you. But if you cover your sin, you are risking His total rejection. Please, don't cover your sin. Ask God for mercy, and He will forgive you. Brother, I want us to read the book of 1 Samuel 15, verse 22 to 29, and our Bible in 1 year, Mark 6, verse 7, our hymn, M22. Amazing grace. Amazing grace. Our action point for today: don't cover your sin. Confess them and repent genuinely. Don't cover your sin. Confess them and repent genuinely. And I know God will forgive you totally. He will help you and He will abide in you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well then, this is the word. Till I come your way tomorrow, don't forget, subscribe to this channel, click on the like button, share with your friends and family, and goodness of God will never leave your life. Have a nice day, and bye for now. God bless you. Once again, I've been away.
Somebody shout hallelujah.